Come up, Patriots, come up, come up, come up, come up, come up, come up. Come up, come up, come up, come up, come up, come up. Come up, Patriots, come up, come up, come up. Come up, Patriots, come up, come up, come up. My phone is getting crazy, guys. I'm sorry. I just come up, come up, come up, Patriots, come up. Come up, Patriots, come up, come up, come up, come up, come up. So, Patriots, let me start with the not so good news, and then we go to the good news. It's important that we, no matter how happy we are, that we must always and never forget the ones that are hurting amongst us. You know, Councillor Dwayne Ponsonby lost his brother, Clayton Ponsonby, today. So Councillor Dwayne Ponsonby lost his brother. So the Ponsonby family, I want to say our deepest and most sincerest condolences to the Ponsonby family. No matter how happy we are, we must always think about the ones that are not happy amongst us. So to Councillor Dwayne Ponsonby, who lost his brother, I want to say to the Ponsonby family, our deepest and most sincerest condolences. We are thinking about you during this time. We've also lost very big, we've lost Leader Regan Olin from Toekomst Rus. It cuts deep because he was a true and true patriot. So to the Olin family from Toekomst Rus, our deepest and most sincerest condolences. Leader Anita Arends from Noordgesig, she lost her mother. So I want to say to Leader Anita Arends and the Arends family, our deepest and most sincerest condolences. And we had a whole agenda, and then we've got our youth was involved in a serious accident. We have Anastasia and we've got Michaela. They're fighting for their lives at the moment. We believe that they will pull through. We have them in our prayers. And I want to say to the family, the leadership of the PA will be there tomorrow. I will also leave everything I'm doing. I'm coming to Kimberley. Nothing is as important like being in Kimberley tomorrow. The Secretary General is already on the way to Kimberley, I'm told. I want to say to you, the family, we know how you feel because we are feeling very, 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 very sad. But we stay on our knees and we are praying. Those children that are five of them that's in hospital will be there tomorrow. And the ones that are out of hospital, tomorrow we're going to sit and I just want to have dinner with you guys tomorrow. Because you are doing the work of PA when you got that accident. And that we should never forget or we should never take for granted. But we know they're going to pull through. And I want to thank Leader Renata and leader Sharifa and all the leaders in Kimberley, they showed true leadership. They were running between hospitals. And while running, they were keeping the leadership that is so far. They kept us up to date by the minute what is happening. Who needs, because we wanted to move them, the others, to a private hospital. And then the doctor said, no, it's going to be difficult. Don't move them. So, yeah, I want to thank the leaders that we are going to be there tomorrow. I will be there tomorrow. Nothing is as important as me being with the family tomorrow. So I'm going to be in Kimberley tomorrow. The Secretary General and the leadership will also be there. Then, where do I start? I just want to say that thank you to President Cyril Ramaphosa that he thought, I know there was a lot of people that didn't want me or the PA to be in this coalition, but President Ramaphosa, when he spoke to me earlier, he did call me and he said, I need you in my cabinet. And that for me was all I needed to hear. I need you. At this point, I need you in my cabinet in this position. And many people will not understand. We wanted Home Affairs, we wanted police, but the ones that truly follow us will know we also mentioned sport. When I had an off the line or off the record conversation with the ANC, off the record, they asked me, which positions are we looking at? Off the record, I said, police, Home Affairs, or sports. Even in, if you can go back, there's some interviews where I said we want sports also. Now, I tell you a story. When I grew up, there was a boy in our street. We will steal, we will rob people, and he will always have a ball under his, a soccer ball under his arm. And we would make fun of him. He was so committed. He never stole. He never committed crime. He was just one boy that was just in soccer. And then I ended up in jail. And when I was in jail, I saw him on TV, that same boy, playing for the national squad, playing for Orlando Pirates. His name is Willem Jackson. Now, Willem Jackson grew up in the same street I grew up in. But Willem Jackson, what separated Willem Jackson from this life that we lived was sport. Eshwin Willem said is another person. Eshwin Willem said was a gangster. And the gang boss told him one day, get out of this nonsense, go play sports. And Eshwin Willem said became the world's top rugby player at the time. Eshwin Willemse went to France. He played in France at 13 in Biarritz. But I can tell you so many stories of the importance of sports and why a child in sports is a child out of court. But I'll tell you this story. One of the people that is still a friend of mine, I was actually seeing him last night. I tell you, I love soccer. I've looked at people play soccer, but I've never in my entire life seen a soccer player like a guy called Neil. Neil went with us to jail. Neil was the best soccer player I've ever seen in my life. I swear, the best. I'm talking about Ronaldo level. For us, Neil, a talent. Like, I've never seen such talent in jail. People will be like, what? What? And Neil was my best friend, and he was with me in jail. And I look at Neil, and I thought, if only Neil was not in crime, he could have walked into the Bafana squad. I then made contact with Orlando Pirates, and I made them come to the prison to come and play. And when they came, they were all asking, how long does Neil still have left in his sentence? That's how good he was. So I know the power of sports. There was a boy I saw, my sons are playing soccer at Panorama. And this boy, my sons are playing soccer. And there's one boy was playing great soccer. And I then asked, what happened to him? And they said, no, there's no team above the team he was playing for, so he's no longer interested in soccer. I then took my money, half a million rand, and I bought them a team. I bought them a team in the ABC League. And I said, the boys must have a stepping stone. Now, this position that the president saw me fit is one that I know the power of. I'm a sports person. I love sports. I went to watch Champions League final. I went to watch the Rugby World Cup. I love sports. I follow sports. I'm passionate about sports. And I also know the discrimination that's happening with poor people. The discrimination that happens with indigenous sport, people in the villages. I have contacts in the world when it comes to sport. So I believe sport can be used to change school sports. Children, a child in sports is a child out of court. And I'm going to make the most of this. And I'm going to show them that I'm a deployee of the Patriotic Alliance and Ons Baizani. We are going to listen to people. We're going to listen to your ideas. You're going to be there with us. But you got to see the difference that we are going to make. And you got to be part of the difference. We are going to work hard, patriots. I'm going to be one of the best ministers. Because I've got you guys. You know, you look at a guy like Marlon Daniels, our national chair. He wouldn't speak about this, but I know how many times he comes asking for money for sports. Can you just help this one, press? Can you help that one? He's so passionate about helping people in sports, and sometimes he gets too passionate. And I'm surrounded by people like that. You have great players that are not playing a role anymore in the sport. Like Mark Williams, Makaya Ntini. Those are the people that we need to bring back. Our children, we're going to stop gangsterism with sports. We're going to stop gangsterism with sports. So I want to thank the PA people because it's your votes that put me here. But I want to, there's one promise I've made. Spinning and stands is not a crime, and you're going to see. I'm so excited because I promised that spinning shall be recognized. And I'm going to keep that promise. I'm going to make spinning one of the biggest sports in this country. Stands is not a crime. Spinning is going to enter the rightful place. People say those things before you vote for them. But now I'm in the position. Now I'm talking the same language. That if the spinners shall be recognized, because it keeps our children. You know, in Mitchell's Plain, when there's a spinning event, it has been proven that shooting goes to zero. While they spin, shooting goes down. So we're not just here for sports. We must use this artist culture. This is sports, arts, and culture. Our children, I'm passionate about swimming pools. I'm passionate about sports. You know, for me, I know if a boy is involved in cars, doesn't have time for drugs, are you worrying it or a car? To all the spinners, I want to say to you, ek is hier, ek het gelandela, ek het seker maak, jylle word gerecognized. I'm going to make sure you are recognized. I'm going to make sure. I'm not saying these things now before I'm getting no vote for me. You voted for us. Now we are here. Combs and them, they're going to come and advise us properly. Culture, the Khoisans. Mpatanga music is world music. These are, you know, I look at some of the artists that makes me, you know, last night I was sitting with Patriots. We had the after thing, after tears. And this one, I've never seen a thing, name is Potter. His boy just come like, hey, I just want to become a singer in my life. I said, sing something. Yo, he just burst in a song. The passion. No, this is not just sports. It's arts and culture. It's museums. People like Ashley Creel. You don't see nothing of them, really. And Ruzondo. These are people we must recognize. The names changes. It falls under us. Videos and film. So read up on this department. Read up when, after my call with the president, I just hit my laptop and I was reading up and I want to thank you. We're going to open all these sports centers. Wherever I drive, I have, let me tell you something. Let me tell you. Five of my cars, three is the panel beaters. And these are my convoy cars. And the other two is a Range Rover. And the insurance gave us other cars. As time away. So 1 week, we did 6,000 kilometers on the car. 1 week, one car. See, the insurance says it can't be. It can't be. It's impossible. We said we do that all the time. Now, wherever I drive in South Africa, we see sports centers being closed, being vandalized. And I'm saying to you, I'm going to make sure. I'm going to make sure that sports, we bring this department to life. We bring fire to it. I'm not a guy that's lazy. I'm not a guy that is just sitting there where I can't add value. We are going to make sure. There's so many departments under this department that I want you to know. But if you are in sport today, I want you to be happy. The drama in school. There's so many people. You have people like Jaislyn Scott and them that can document our history of our people. We're going to do well together because I didn't bring myself here. You brought me here. The pools that's not being fixed, where people want 10 million rands or 20 million to fix a pool, and you know that's going to cost us under a million. Those are the things we need to look at. Jobs for our people. And we're not done negotiating. I must also be honest with you. We are still negotiating other positions in the GNU, which I will share as we go because the negotiations are still ongoing. we are going to fix. We are, we are going to fix our youth. We're going to use sport to get children from the street, to get children out of crime, We're going to use the sports portfolio. We are going to work. We're going to bring, you know, I look at people in El Rado Park, Peter Rafferty and them, and Jerome and them. These are people that they're so passionate about marathons. We need to bring the marathons. I'm just mentioning all these things because my heart is full and I want you to know, I want you to feel my heartbeat. I'm going to sit and I'm going to have all my plans. Don't let people tell you this appointment is not massive. This is a massive appointment. Event that's going to be organized. Do you know, like, for me, just the drama and all the sketches and Toniel Spiel. The Khoisan culture. The Khoisan culture that's being ignored and there's so many cultures in the Vendas and Tongas that being ignored. The Okapai moet faal. The kinders moet weer interest in sport. I'm going to do all those things and I'm going to document it every time in their lives. Die kom op, gaan nog aan. Moenie dink 'n minister gaan vir my change. I'm going to bring e-sport. I'm going to make car spinning. Guys, hulle verstaan nie. You've been treated like dogs. You've been treated like dogs. Tyd is oor. We're going to have massive competitions. You wanna get big competitions with big prize monies. So I'm not even in yet. Already I've had a call. You see, what time is it? I wanna show you something. It's my other phone. I'm not even in yet. And I'm already speaking to people that says to me, we always wanted to help in sport, but we were just told no. People want to get involved. So you know what's funny? You look at the schools in Aldous, for instance, El Rado Park or in Heidedal. They don't have the same sporting coats that all the kids had. There's no water polo in Heidedal. Sometimes there's the next biggest water polo star lives in Heidedal, lives in El Rado Park, but because of finances, those kids don't get a chance. In Deep Kloof, maybe there in Deep Kloof is a top boat water polo child, but because it's not that, we're gonna bring back the jazz festivals. The jazz festivals. How that department is being run now is not how it will be run going forward. I can tell you that now. How that department is being run now is not how it will be run going forward. Local tournaments, we're gonna bring that back. That's what your vote did. That's what your vote did. Don't let them lie to you. Gayton Mckenzie didn't bring himself here. It's your vote. And you guys didn't vote for me. It's okay. Was kicked no forum to. You will see what it means. When we said, we're going to break the curse. There's some areas with no swimming pools. How can that be? Indoor soccer, old people, roll ball. poetry. Children that's in poetry mustn't, boys that's in poetry mustn't feel, it's not a manly thing. Or boys that wants to do something that's not rugby or this macho sport. No. I'm going to need you to be successful in this post. I can't do it without you. Ons gaat werk, mensen. We are going to work. Die werk begin nou. I'm telling you, I'm speaking. The ex-boss of Arsenal, I spoke to him. The ex-boss of Arsenal, he says, listen, I want to get involved with ex-prisoners in soccer. I said, let's stop that bus right there. Not only ex-prisoners, I'm going to get you young people that they just don't grow. But I'm here because of you. And I'm going to hear the old man's roll ball. I'm not going to come sleep in that department. I can tell you, sleeping is over. Sleeping is over. We are going to work. We are going to work. Krevi el rech. We are going to do work. We are bringing sports back. We as members of the over 40s, the old crocs, we must bring that sports back. So I'm just trying to give you, like, I'm still going to see where's the office, where's the bathroom in the office, I don't know. But I need you to know. And what I want you to know, which is the last and most important thing I want to say to you tonight. And this is the most serious thing I'm going to say now. I hear people talk about blue lights. I hear people talk about, oh yeah, now he's going to be a minister. Whatever, listen, whatever car they're going to give me there is a downgrade from the cars I have. I can promise you that. I'm not there for those things. I don't start with this. I'm not there for those things. I'm there for our people. But there's a lesson for everybody here, PA or no PA. I have a lesson for you. Keep your eye on the price. They were talking about me. They were making posts daily about me. They were talking nonsense. They were making videos about me. I was just focused. Look where our focus brought me to. Die tracksuit wat ek aangehad het was seker 'n sign. But be focused. Let them talk. Let them talk. Ek wil sommer heel van bly giet. Nie vir my nie, vir ons mense. The musicians, let me tell you something, and I don't even want to say it, but I'm going to say it. It is just a handful of musicians that benefit there. A handful. The usual suspects. The item is klaar. It's over. Talent is going to be recognized. Indigenous music will be recognized. We don't just want celebrity people here. Watch our artists. TV must tell our stories. I'm excited about this thing. The libraries. I'm excited because I used to love libraries. I'm excited because I love libraries. Patriots, I love you. I care about you. There will be lives tomorrow. Money buys any. I just need to answer. There's a lot of, I see, like, I just need to think, but I am here because of you. Mani Baizani, salute. I'm here because of you. We're going to work. Temple boys must be happy tonight. Bye. Temple. Losada. Bye.